Three Musketeers. It's a film that I've always wanted to make.
There's sword fighting.
We'll be showing stuff on screen that has never been seen.
This really fantastic contemporary action adventure movie.
It's very elaborate.
What's brilliant about this is that we're bringing 21st century technology to a 400-year-old story. Now that's clever.
It's really young and it's really fun.
There were four of us against 40 of them.
Was it 40? Or was it 400?
Just 40. It was an off day.
I'm known as an action director, so if I'm going to make The Three Musketeers, you know it's going to have action in it. And I really wanted to step up my game here.
All the settings, all the fights, he's a master of that. It goes very much down his alley of filmmaking with Resident Evil.
The Musketeers, who were kind of like 17th century rock stars.
The Three Musketeers are the King's Guards, and they're elite soldiers.
I wanted the sword fighting to look real. Real swords with people really fighting. There are no stunt doubles in the movie.
We trained for like 4 months.
There's no faking it. There's no slicing a sword 3 foot away from somebody's face.
You get hit with one of these things, it hurts. You can see when the blades meet, there are actual sparks coming off the blades.
My character is fighting like 8 or 10 guards.
With the big skirts, with the big petticoats. She was fighting with 2 swords and spinning over people's backs.
It's the first female action sequence in a corset and a big dress.
They have some fancy gadgets and gimmicks. The swords, daggers, muskets.
Paul's forward-thinking in his weaponry. It's like James Bond, where they open the secret panel and there's all these crazy guns, and we have all these amazing weapons.
It's impressive what they've done, and it's going to put another dimension to what we can do in this film.
It's got these incredible themes that transcend time.
Courage, honor, all for one.
It's that fantasy when you're a kid running around the house with sticks or whatever, pretending like you're sword fighting, and everybody wants to be one of the musketeers.
But you can say it's loyalty, it's patriotism, but I think they all believe in love. That's ultimately what they'll fight and die for. A love for each other, love for France, love for adventure.
I have the best job in the world.
This is definitely a version of the Musketeers that isn't your parents' version and it's not your grandparents' version.
Every generation should have their version of Three Musketeers.
It's going to be a real feast for the eyes.